Guys, I come to you guys a little defeated. The first night, no money spent. The first stream was pretty rough. We went 10-5 against all types of bots. Nobody that good, nobody that great, just absolute the most random Madden players on the leaderboards. We went 10-5, man. If you guys want to watch No Money Mondays, twitch.tv/dub. Those links are below. Please follow my social medias to keep up to date with this no money spent team. So I played 15 games. So I was able to make about 40K coins. Now, I added two people to the team that would help me keep going future endeavors. Now, the best card, which I actually don't have in this gameplay coming up, is Russell Okung, who is a 82 overall left tackle. But the good thing about him is he has built-in edge protector. So he gives you extra edge protection against those edge threats and those good pass rushers, as everybody does rush three and try to get to you. So that's a bonus, because I damn sure don't have enough training to go ahead and get abilities on my offensive tackles. But let's take a look at the team. If you guys did not watch my last video, this is the team right now. This is how we're living. Let me move my face, make sure you guys see this whole thing. We have Evan Engram at tight end. He's been solid. I don't really need to think I need to upgrade my tight end spot. We have this Okung, and we have Andrew Whitworth. In this game, I just have Andrew Whitworth. I just bought Okung. That was my last piece. Still have Jerry Jeudy. I'm telling you guys, Jerry Jeudy is the best player I learned from this No Money Spent team. If you guys are looking for a wide receiver, 84 overall, this wide receiver is about 60K, an absolute steal. So if you guys are looking for a wide receiver, if you're in the market to try to upgrade that spot, Jerry Jeudy is a boss. Got Lamar Jackson. I feel like once they put the new Lamar Jackson out, this regular powered up Lamar Jackson, not that great. Lamar Miller, he's holding it down. This is probably my first spot I want to upgrade after today. Next Monday is Lamar Miller. I think I want to get that Cam Akers card. I have McCaffrey. I have Ruggs. I could go get, people were telling me Justin Jefferson. The team builder is just as good as Jeudy. Ruggs, although I wanted him for his speed, but I'm so far behind in speed because I don't have power-ups. I don't have sprinter. 89 speed is not going to really get it done. So I might as well get a better route runner like Jefferson or somebody like that rather than Ruggs. So between the running back and Ruggs, there's spots I need to upgrade. Plus, I definitely need to upgrade the offensive line. I mean, it looks like it can hold up. It can't hold up. I'm just getting killed by the offensive line. Defense, the one person I added from the last one was Denzel Ward. Denzel Ward was about 20K. Got him after like my first season. Put him out there outside with Dante Jackson. So that's enough speed on the outside to hold me down. Justin Reed, Savage, like I said, Watt, Chubb, they're pretty solid. DeMarcus Lawrence, Montez Sweat, Pat Pete in the slot. We have Apke. We have rookie. We have rookie old Isaiah Simmons I've been using. So that's my team. That's how we're working. I'll be honest, man. I thought it'd be a little easier. I thought I'd be able to probably win about 80% of my games. I won about 66% of my games last night. It was rough. I think without Weekend League, it's going to be hard to build this team. Without the level packs, without Weekend League, and without playing Draft Champions, this is going to be a grind. And I'm only playing on Monday. So I'm not going to put a lot of time in this team. I'm not going to put any money. We're going to play Mondays, and we're going to play over the weekend when Weekend League comes out. We're going to play 25 games of Weekend League and Mondays. That's going to be how I grind this team. But let's get into this gameplay. I'll show you guys what I had to do to fight with this team. All right, one of the main things, I've been kind of struggling offense. And right there, we see Lamar Jackson throwing on a run. Actually threw right at his user. And it goes to the crib. So that's not the best way to start a game, especially if you're already down in team. The one thing I realized through the games that I lost and the games I was struggling in is, man, I was turning the ball over, forcing too much stuff, not comfortable in the pocket. I don't think my receivers held me back, but I think the offensive line, these double teams break down so fast. As you see there, team captain Ed McCaffrey creating separation on man coverage. And you see a lot of, there I go, Evan Engram over the middle. I see a lot of these guys run this man coverage. So you need guys that can get open on man coverage. Right there again, McCaffrey, boom, beating Trey Wayne. Speed isn't all that matters. McCaffrey making big plays for me so far early with this team. But here it is. Just that edge threat breaks the sack, breaks through the double team that fast, and I don't pick to the spy after getting hit, and he takes it to the crib. So two pick sixes in the first drive. It's rough to come back from that. I don't care if you have a 99 overall, a 69 overall, a 13 overall. If you go two pick sixes your first two drives, you're going to have to fight. But that's all I do is fight. That's why they watch. We're going to fight. We're just going to keep keep plugging away. Like I said, most people do this three-man rush. I want these double teams to hold up a little bit longer, but I can get the ball to McCaffrey. If you guys see any offense, defense that you guys like, man, check out MaddenTurf.com. The Seattle Seahawks ebook is out now, man. Make sure you guys check that out. Like I said, I'm playing with Drek right now and being able to move on Dre Bly and you know, Asante Samuel and all the goons out there as I hit Ingram in the flats. Got to take your flats when it's there. We get to a fourth and two. Got to find somebody. We hit the in route. Jerry Jeudy absolutely frying right there. I'm telling you, that Jerry Jeudy card is something serious. We're going to take off up the middle with Lamar Jackson. Get a first down just like that. We're back inside the red zone looking to make a play. Post route, Jeudy over the middle. The Broncos rookie, Alabama standout, gets me inside the 10-yard line. First and goal. Try to run. That's the one thing I realized. It's really tough to run with this team, and we get sacked on second down. So we get to a third and goal, man. We got to be able to get a touchdown here. We got to find some way, and we hit Ingram over the middle in route. Good draw up, good play call, good execution, touchdown, cut the lead in half. And it's already been three scores, and this guy hasn't played offense at all. That's always an advantage if you can, you know, get points without playing offense, because I don't know any of his plays. I don't know any of his offense or anything, but he's running a bunch. So kind of familiar with what to do. I've been running nickel normal. I like it. The ebook is out now on Madden Turf, the defensive one. I'm going to fine-tune my own as Troy Apke picks off the running back wheel, and he's going to take it to the Baja just like that. Troy Apke tying the game up. Troy Apke is pretty much one of the best budget players in the history of Madden. In fact, there's going to be a new MVP card of Troy Apke coming out hopefully this week. I don't know. So he might have upwards of 90, 91 speed. Definitely will probably have to add that card to the team in the future here. But Apke, man, if you guys are looking for budget players, go get yourself a Troy Apke. He throws the ball underneath right here. Rally, make some plays. Get him to a nice third and long. Try to get him to a fourth right here. We scream off the edge, but he hits Jeudy underneath. We stop him short of that line, though. Get him to a fourth down. What are we going to do? We're going to get off the field right here, and he hits the running back wheel route to Akers. Nice play, man. It's hard to cover the whole field sometimes, and that's always the route I seem to give up. Right here, Marino on the run, throwing the ball in front of Denzel Ward. Denzel Ward, you got to step up, man. That's a cloud flat. I need you to play that going forward in this game. I need you to play more aggressive. I need you to make some big plays. Tie game going in a half here. He dumps it off again to Jerry Jeudy inside the 20-yard line. There's 30 seconds left. I'm going to try to play safe. Try to keep everything in front of me. I put my cloud zones at 20 right here. And I think that's safe enough to go ahead and not give up this corner route, which I do. So I should have put my clouds at 25. I put them at 20 with the zone adjustment feature. I should have put them at 25. I give up a touchdown right there. So I'm back down 7 with 20 seconds left. I have done more with less before half. So we got to go ahead and make something shake, try to get some points. And we're going up top to my man Marquise Goodwin, Philadelphia Eagle great. I believe he opted out of the season, though, so I don't know if he's a Philadelphia Eagle great. We try to hit him again up the middle, but we get hit. I'm telling you, with these gold O linemen, they break these double teams so fast. Again, we hit McCaffrey, though. Boom. Great pass lead on the vertical route. Great positioning with the wide receiver. Make sure his body was in front of the DBs. Scored a touchdown. Tie the game up. Like I told you, I have done more with less. Now we just got to hold him out of field goal range, hold him out of getting points before half. I'm cool with being tied. After throwing two pick sixes, I would have signed up for a tie in a heartbeat. Hits the corner right here, but that's the end of the half. We're going to go into halftime. I'm cool. My team is fighting. My boys are out here. They laced up their cleats. This 78 overall team has laced up their cleats just like the 87s and the 88 overalls. We're cool. My boy Troy Apke fighting off the edge right there, making the tackle. Just got to keep everything. There it is. Fumble. TJ Watt. Apke picks it up. Apke is all over the field. Second trip to the Baja for Troy Apke. Just like that, we take the lead 28-21. Apke's all over the field, man. Get yourself an Apke. TJ Watt with that block shed and the strip sack. So we have the lead now, man. He's got two defensive touchdowns. I have two defensive touchdowns. That's what you like to see, you know, when you're on the defensive side of the ball. Your boy's getting after it. Your boy's making plays. And you know it's mutt, so they're going to switch in Lamar Jackson just to run a read option because they're that bagged. They got to resort to anything. We get another huge sack right there. Free DeMarcus Lawrence, man. If you guys had those loyalty plaques, I use this free DeMarcus Lawrence making plays right there. Pat Pete, I need a pick right there. swats the ball away. Third and 17. Got to keep everything in front of me right here. A little rollout, and I give up the corner route. Apke, I was singing his prayer. And Judy's going to go to the crib. No, my man Darnell Savage, 89 speed, stops him at the one. But this team doesn't have a lot of fight in its boots when it's time for the trenches, man. They got to save it. They can't fight every trench possession. They got to save it from when we need it. So it's 28-28. Barn burner. Why they watch? Got to make some plays with my man Goodwin, with my man Jerry Judy and Ed McCaffrey. Got to find somewhere to go with the ball. Judy, quick out route, get the yards, take what's there. That's what we got to do. My man right here, Lamar Miller. Oh, that's Taylor, the rookie Taylor. He's kind of a dog too. We're going to hit up, roll out right here, hit my man Jerry Judy. Jerry Judy's all over the field. I'm telling you guys, if there's two cards, if you're a budget team and you're struggling for cards, Jerry Judy, Troy Apke should be somewhere on your field. Give them a chance to shine because they are shining for me. We're going to try to milk right here. We got to try to take our time, but we're able to hit this drag route. Once again, Jerry Judy, boom. Get inside the 20-yard line. Time is running out. We're going to run the ball with Lamar Miller. Excuse me, miss stop right there and take that one to the Baja. Lamar Miller, huge touchdown. Go up by 7. 3 minutes left in the game. Plenty of time left, but I feel good because the clock is my friend here. Just listen, my team is not the fastest. We can't play man, bump, and run, but we can send some heat. Patrick Peterson's second sack of the game. If you guys want all these blitzes, man, MaddenTurf.com, they will hold you down. Keep him in bounds right there. We're at the 2 minute warning. What can we do? Rolls out right here, and I send Patrick Peterson. I gotta do a better job. That was terrible execution by myself. Gotta click on Pat Pete and not allow that to happen to Judy. He's at the 37 yard line, closing in for a touchdown. Hits the little streak up the middle. He's inside the 20 now, 13 yard line, 1 minute 20 seconds left. He's gonna roll out with Dan Marino. He's gonna hit the corner route, but no, Denzel Ward, fresh off the auction house, fresh off the just absolutely getting fried all first half. Denzel Ward is taking his own trip to the Baja to seal the game, man. That is why we went out and bought Denzel Ward. That is why we upgraded that corner position. I could not have a gold card out there. We got Denzel Ward, the new addition, making a huge play to seal the game up. Baja trips, a lot of Baja trips for my team right here. So we go up 2 scores, and that's pretty much going to cook the game. At this point, you know you won. You just got to play deep zones, give up no one-play touchdowns, make them use their timeouts. At this point in the game, you know they're going to need an onside kick to beat you. Keep them in bounds. That's the key, as we do right here. Make them no huddle. It's only 30 seconds left in the game. This is absolutely cooked. No big plays. He catches that, actually has to use his last timeout. But as you see, with the runoff and mutt now, man, he's down to 20 seconds. Throws another one underneath, and we're able to let Akers get out of there. But Dante Jackson catches him with that 89 speed, cackles him in bounds, and that will do it. GG's in the chat. Listen, when you buy cards fresh off the auction block, put them in the game, let them make plays, man. No money spent. It was rough, man, but I'm having fun, man. If you guys like this series, if you think this series can pop, please hit that like button and let me know.